Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the management of patients with gagging. So the first step is individual assessment. We need to assess the patient's attitude and motivation towards the treatment. Their willingness to try the treatment and invest time in treatment should be recorded. The patient should accept that the treatment may be prolonged, and we as a dentist should reassure the patient that gagging is a normal response. Many patients have very sensitive gag reflex. The majority of them can learn to control gagging, but it takes time, and there is nothing to be embarrassed about. Next comes the behavioral techniques. They are used to reduce the anxiety and unlearn the behaviors that provoke gagging. It includes relaxation techniques. When treating any patient, dentists should acknowledge that operative procedures can produce stress and anxiety. Dentists must adopt empathetic and caring chairside manners to relax the patients. There are two forms of relaxation, active and passive. Passive forms include avoiding an obvious display of instruments, using soothing pictures and music in reception areas and surgeries, and active forms involves breathing exercises like controlled rhythmic breathing and relaxed abdominal breathing. Then comes the distraction techniques. Distraction techniques are taught to work by diverting the patient's attention away from the gagging problem for long enough to carry out a particular procedure. This makes the patient concentrate on a task or thought that completely absorbs the mind, so preventing the individual from focusing on gagging and increasing the anxiety. So you can simply talk to the patient, or you can ask the patient to raise one of their legs during impression making and concentrate on keeping it there for the duration of the procedure. So next is systemic desensitization. Systemic desensitization aims to produce permanent effects in contrast to the distraction techniques. The technique consists of incremental exposure of the patient to the feared stimulus. The patient, under conditions of relaxation and reassurance, is exposed to increasingly aversive stimulus and learns to cope with this. Many re-education techniques have been described, in which the patient is given an object to place in the mouth for a period of time. The size of the object and length of time for which it is held in the mouth gradually increases until the patient is able to tolerate the dental procedures. So this involves progressive use of small to full size denture bases. It is useful for patients who are to become denture wearers. In this technique, a thin acrylic denture base without teeth is fabricated, and the patient is asked to wear it at home, gradually increasing the length of time for which the training base is used. Next is marble technique. Singer developed a common sense approach to the problem of accustoming hopeless gaggers to complete denture processes. This technique involves total 7 visits. So during first visit, no oral examination of any kind is made. 5 round multicolored glass marbles, approximately 1/2 inch in diameter, are given to the patient, and patient is asked to put them in the mouth one at a time at his comfort until all 5 are in the mouth. During the second visit, if the patient reports that he is able to tolerate the 5 marbles, then he is given assurance that he would be able to wear the dentures. During third visit, preliminary impressions are made after applying topical anesthesia. The stone casts are poured and base plates are made. Base plates are not highly polished. On the contrary, they are sandblasted to give them a dull finish. During fourth visit, the lower base plate is inserted and the patient is asked to continue to keep 3 marbles in his mouth in addition to the base plate. A training bead is placed on the lingual aspect of the lower central incisors to help the patient maintain a proper tongue position. Then during the fifth visit, the upper denture base is inserted and the patient is asked to keep both of them in the mouth continually except while eating. And use of marbles are continued. During sixth visit, patient is now able to endure the presence of both base plates. Then the occlusal rims are used to establish the jaw relations, and during this visit, try-in is completed. During the seventh visit, the completed lower dentures are inserted. Next is error-less learning. This desensitization technique is helpful for the patients who have dentures but do not wear them because the dentures evoke gagging. The disadvantage is that it can be a very slow technique. In this, the patient is instructed to set aside time to position the denture closer each day and eventually into the mouth in successive approximations. That is, the denture is placed perhaps millimeters at a time closer to the final position. The process is repeated with a small increase in time spent undertaking this task until eventually the patient can wear the denture. Next is acupuncture. Acupuncture is a system of medicine in which a fine needle is inserted through the skin to a depth of few millimeters, left in place for a time, sometimes manipulated and then withdrawn. So ear acupuncture is selected for the following reason. There is a specific recognized anti-gagging point on the ear. The needles are not disturbed during access to the mouth and the needles are out of the patient's line of vision. So in this, single-use disposable needles of 7 mm length are placed into the anti-gagging point of each ear to a depth of 3 mm. The needles are manipulated for 30 seconds prior to carrying out dental treatments. The needles remain in situ throughout the treatment and are removed before the patient is discharged. The patient does not require an escort and is not inconvenient in any way following treatment. The advantages are that it is a relatively non-invasive procedure. It is a cheap and quick procedure. The patient does not require an escort during the treatment and they can return to normal daily activities after treatment. However, it is important that informed consent is gained prior to the treatment. Next is acupressure. Acupressure follows the same principle as acupuncture but stimulates the points with gentle finger pressure rather than using fine needles. It is a less invasive technique. For this, we have different points. The Hegu point is found between the first and second metacarpal bones, the bones of the thumb and the first finger. It lies at the highest point formed when the thumb is brought to rest against the index finger. Then we have Chen Jiang point. So Vachiravon stated that gag reflex could be eliminated during maxillary impression procedures by applying light finger pressures on Chen Jiang situated in the horizontal mentolabial groove, approximately midway between the chin and the lower lip. The acupressure procedure should start at least 5 minutes before impression making, continue through the impression procedures and terminated only after the impression has been removed from the patient's mouth. In this, light finger pressure is applied with the index finger. The pressure is progressively increased until the patient feels soreness and distension. The procedure should start at least 5 minutes before impression making, continue through the impression procedures, and terminated only after the impression has been removed from the patient's mouth. Next is hypnosis. So hypnosis is a waking state of awareness in which a person's attention is detached from his or her immediate environment and is absorbed by inner experiences such as feelings, cognition, and imagery. Hypnosis is contraindication in cases of poorly motivated patients, if the patient is under severe depression, and in patients who are receiving treatment for psychosis. So if you like this video, then please share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.